And today I have another tag video for you. This is the musical theater tag, and I was tagged by Michael over at Bitten by a Radioactive Book a while ago because I'm horrible. I'm so sorry. It takes me forever to get to these, but I'm doing it now. And by the way, if you haven't heard of Michael and you love fantasy, go check him out immediately. But anyways, on with the tag. First up, we have Wicked, which I really do want to see in real life. It looks amazing. And for this, I have to pick my favorite fictional friendship. I'm actually going to forego some of my obvious choices on this because I feel like I mention the same series all the time, so I kind of want to mix it up a little bit. So I'm gonna go with Gently and Estravon from The Left Hand of Darkness by Ursula K. Le Guin. These two characters have a very complicated relationship because essentially Gently is kind of an alien on this planet. He's an envoy from this place called the Yukmin, which is I think just this really big company in space that is involved in trading information between all these different planets that all have humans on them that didn't know the others existed before. And he's trying to convince this planet that they should join in on this information trade, and Estravon is the person that's supposed to be helping Gently get in good with the government and convince them that this is a good idea. In the beginning, Gently doesn't trust Estravon at all. He thinks that he's actually hindering him, and he makes all of these decisions that then Estravon has to get him out of, because obviously being the outsider, there are certain things that Gently just doesn't understand about the way that this planet and this culture works. And it's just really interesting seeing their relationship change over time, especially because Estravon comes and helps him out of a lot of tight spots, no matter how much Gently doesn't trust him, like he still comes to his aid, and it's just a really interesting friendship, and I like seeing the way it develops by the end. Next up we have Sweeney Todd, and I have to talk about my favorite villain. I think I'm actually gonna go with Count Olaf for this one, from the series of Unfortunate Events. He's just a very creative and menacing figure, and so I just enjoy his inventiveness, even though he's actually extremely scary. For number three we have Phantom of the Opera, and for this I have to pick my favorite love triangle. Can my answer just be no? Like, just no. I'm not really a big fan of love triangles. I try to avoid them when possible because most of the time they're just incredibly frustrating and obnoxious. If I have to pick one, I guess I'll go with The Hunger Games, just because the Katniss, Peeta, Gale thing is a very background part of the books. Like, Katniss is sitting there going, can we worry about this after, like, we make sure we don't die first? Because definitely can't be with either of you if you're both dead. I just really enjoy the fact, too, that Gale and Peeta don't actually dislike one another or even interact all that much. It doesn't feel like a competition. Next up for number four is The Lion King, and for this I have to pick my favorite sidekick. This is an obvious choice for me. I have to go with Samwise Gamgee, aka Samwise the Brave, aka the most awesome person that ever happened. Well, Hobbit, but you know what I mean. Because I mean, think about it. They would not have gotten very far, as in him and Frodo, if he hadn't come along. Like, Frodo never would have made it without Sam. I do have to give a quick honorable mention, though. This is a completely different book and genre, but I have to go with Tiny Cooper from Will Grayson, Will Grayson by John Green and David Levithan, because he's fabulous and hopefully is getting his own book this year, because I think David Levithan is writing out the musical that Tiny talks about and performs in Will Grayson, Will Grayson, and I will read the crap out of that because I love Tiny. So yeah, Sam and Tiny. Number five is Grease, and for this I have to pick my least favorite ending. You know, I was gonna say Maximum Ride, but it's been brought to my attention that apparently they're gonna actually keep milking this after all, even though they said the seventh book was the last book and wrapped it up clumsily and terribly. Apparently they're bringing it back as Maximum Ride Forever, which quite frankly sounds like a threat more than anything else. I can't even talk about it, but that is my answer, and I'm gonna pretend like this eighth book coming out doesn't exist, because it shouldn't. Number six is Matilda the musical, and for this one I have to pick my favorite adaptation of a book. I want to say Lord of the Rings because I adore those movies, but I haven't actually finished the second two books, so I don't feel like I can say that because I don't know everything that they left out yet. So instead, I'm gonna go with Catching Fire just because it's like the closest and most true adaptation I've seen in a really long time, and it has a great soundtrack, and just the whole thing was just really well executed. So I think I'm gonna go with Catching Fire. And finally, we have number seven, which is Les Mis, and for this, I have to pick my favorite death in a book, and I'm not entirely sure what that means. If it's like the death that affected me the most and made me the most heartbroken, or like the most epic death, but because I'm talking about a character death here, obviously this is going to be a bit spoilery, so if you have not read A Storm of Swords in the A Song of Ice and Fire series, or you have not watched up to the end of season 3 in the TV show, then you might want to skip to the end. No, I'm not going to talk about the Red Wedding. Actually, something else. Okay, if you're still here, I assume that means that I can say the name now. So my favorite death is going to have to be Tywin Lannister's during A Storm of Swords, just because it was so many things at once. It was like darkly hilarious, and it was satisfying, but also kind of sad, and just very intriguing. I didn't like Tywin, obviously, I don't think very many people do, but I did think he was extremely interesting, and he was the puppet master, really. He was the biggest power player, and so having him gone just changed everything. And so politically, it was a huge deal, and then personally, like seeing Tyrion be the one to do it was both intensely satisfying and also really sad, because like, poor Tyrion, he's got such a crappy family situation. And then again, also funny, because like, he's just sitting there on the toilet and Tyrion's like, oh well, nope, what a weird way to go. And that's it. So thank you again to Michael for tagging me, and I will tag some people down below, and if you want to do this and you haven't yet, then I tag you as per usual. And that's it for me. So this has been a tag video. My name is Jackie, and I will see you guys pretty soon. Bye!